Clinigen is a specialty pharmaceuticals and services business focused on delivering the right drug to the right patient at the right time. It listed on the alternative investment market here in London back in September last year, and its customer base is very wide. It consists of pharmaceutical companies, biotech companies and contract research organisations. So we're talking now to Peter George, the Chief Executive, and the Chief Financial Officer, Robin Sibson. Gentlemen, welcome.
Thank you.
The introduction there is quite long because you seem to be doing quite a lot of things. I know the company's broadly split up into three completely separate areas, but you do seem to be many things to many organisations. Peter, first of all, how is what's the detail in how the company's split?
Well, in two of our operating businesses, we provide services to pharmaceutical companies. So in Clinigen CTS, we supply drugs into clinical trial. So for large pharma companies that are running clinical trials on novel drugs, we will supply other drugs that they need to run their clinical trial successfully, drugs they're going to compare to, and other drugs the patient might need for their well-being. So that's what clinical trial supply does. And then we have Clinigen Gap, which does global access programs. So this is making other companies' drugs available where there is an unmet need in the market. Now, that might be drugs that haven't been launched yet, so they might still be in clinical trial, but there are no alternative treatments for patients who have that disease, and they may be showing very good efficacy in clinical trial, so they'll be made available early. It may be drugs that haven't been launched in certain markets, so they're launched in maybe the top 10 pharmaceutical markets around the world, but not in others, and we can make them available in those non-launch markets. Or it may be drugs that have been withdrawn from the market, and we can continue to make them available where patients in certain niche disease areas benefit from those drugs. So if there's an unmet need, we can make them available. So those are the two, if you like, service businesses, which where we work with other pharmaceutical companies. And then there is Clinigen SP, which is our specialty pharmaceutical division, where we are acquiring the IP and the rights to drugs on a global basis to supply ourselves into the market. And that's where we have the drugs that we've acquired from AstraZeneca, Foscovir, Cardioxane and Verbative are our current three products that we supply.
There would seem to me, from what you say, to be lots of synergies between the first two areas and not perhaps maybe so much between those and the third. But
The synergies are definitely between the three. And interestingly enough, there's probably a greater synergy between the second and the third than there is. Well, the way that we describe it is that the Clinigen Gap, the global access business, I describe as the glue between the other two. So for the early access programs where drugs have not yet been licensed, they're still in clinical trial, it's the same customer base as we would be supplying drugs into clinical trial. So there's a synergy there in the customer base. But drugs that have not yet been launched in certain markets and drugs that are being withdrawn, they become very interesting acquisition targets for Clinigen SP. So there's a really big synergy between the Gap and the SP business in identifying potential acquisitions. And in fact, our latest two acquisitions have come to our attention through initial Gap activity rather than SP activity.
Well, it's interesting, actually, Peter, talking about those, Robin, because the acquisitions presumably have had some bearing on the recently reported results. I mean, just to look at some of the numbers here, you've got an 86% growth in sales to 61 million, resulting in a 54% rise, I think, in underlying pre-tax profit to £9.7 million. First of all, how widely across the business are these numbers spread?
Yeah, the good news is that all three operating businesses have delivered strong growth, and in the interim results, that's all organic growth. So what we've seen is the CTS business has been the biggest contributor, so that's contributed £24 million in growth, or something like 113% year on year. And then our Gap business has delivered 222% from a relatively small base, but is growing well. And our specialty pharma business, growth of 22%, so really good growth across all three operating businesses.
But that's only the organic side, isn't it? So you've got the acquisitions as well to add in.
No acquisition in that at that point. On the profit side, the good news is profit from all the businesses as well. So the profits delivering about half of the growth from CTS business, a third from the specialty pharma business, and the balance from the Gap business.
So when will we get the new acquisitions in the next set?
The new acquisitions came shortly after the interims, so we acquired Cardioxane and Vibativ in March. And there will be a small contribution in the final results, but relatively small. We'll start to see the growth in FY14 from those two products.
You've got a global footprint, haven't you?
We have.
How widely spread is the... I mean, you talked about how widely spread the numbers are amongst your business, but how about globally?
Yeah, globally it's very well spread as well. So clearly the US is a fairly significant market, and Europe, but we have... business all over the globe, and the UK a relatively small part of our business.
Mm. We've spoken about some interesting growth numbers, especially in the current economic environment. First of all, are you insulated from the economy? And the other obvious question is, can these sort of growth rates continue?
Yeah, I think the key is our services, and indeed our products are very, very niche, so that provides a degree of ongoing demand and therefore does provide some insulation, and they're global, so... It isn't just certain economies that affect us. Can the growth rates continue? The sort of percentage rates that we've delivered will be harder to deliver as our business becomes much bigger, but we certainly expect continued growth next year. We expect continued organic growth in the CTS business and in the GAP business. On the products business, we'll have both acquisitional growth but also some organic growth on those acquired products.
Well, this presents an interesting case then to investors, doesn't it? Because you've got everything in place, apparently, and looking good. What are you working on at the moment?
Well, I mean, we're always working on potential acquisitions of products. And, you know, our intention is over the next 3 to 5 years is to add another 5 to 7 products. That's what we're looking to do. That's our goal. So we have a number of potential acquisitions in the pipeline, and you know, hopefully some of those will come to fruition. What we're looking for is hospital only niche products. That our target when we acquire a product is to at least double the turnover of that product in a 3-year period. So we're not just looking to bolt on products that, you know, add a degree of sales. We're looking to actually drive organic growth through that product as well. So hospital-only, niche, growth potential products where we've seen a growth potential in it. And that's bolted on to our global distribution network that we have. So that's our main focus at the moment. And then it's about driving organic growth through the services businesses. We're targeting being the number one clinical trial supplier in the world, for example. And we've grown that business significantly over the last 3 years, and we think there's still a lot of organic growth to go through that business. Mm. Within the global access, we're targeting being the number one player in global access worldwide. Mm. So, you know, what we're working on is the bolt-ons to those businesses that continue to make an attractive proposition. You know, we are global. We are capable of delivering both licensed and unlicensed products worldwide, which nobody else is. Mm. So those are the things that differentiate us.
Finally, and very briefly, headlines. You got anything up your sleeve you want to talk about that you think might be breaking before the end of the year?
Well, certainly not before the end of our financial year, because we've just come to that.
Right. But, we've got another 12 months to talk about.
I mean, the things that we are always focused on is we're looking to strengthen our global footprint, and that's something. The acquisition of Cardioxane has really enabled us to strengthen our capabilities in South America. So what we're now looking to do is how do we strengthen our capability in Asia? So that's something that we're very focused on and working on at the moment. Product acquisition, I mean, acquisition is always about, it's not just what we want to buy, it's what people want to sell. So those will be dependent on timing of, because we're acquiring from big pharma, so we're dependent on big pharma timings on those type of things. But certainly strengthening our footprint is a very important thing for us.
Okay, well, good luck with that. Gentlemen, thanks for joining me.
Thank you.
Okay, that's Peter George, the Chief Executive there of Clinigen, and the CFO, Robin Sibson.